I bring you on a journey in your friendly neighbourhood mangrove, Sungai Buloh, home to an abundance of animals like the migratory birds and the mudskippers. It is important because it is the first protected wetland reserve in Singapore. In 1986, a group of bird enthusiasts called for the protection of the mangroves because Sungai Buloh hosted an unusually high variety of migratory birds. Today, it remains pertinent to Singapore's survival against climate change. Let me tell you why. Mangroves in Sungai Buloh are grown in layers. The back zone begins with tall trees covered in epiphytes, such as the bird's nest fern and strangler figs, a common sight in tropical rainforests. Associated trees such as the fishtail palm and sea almond are common too. Ephemeral channel paths drain water from the terrestrial lands quickly into the sea during storm floods, while the weaving buttress and knee roots of the brugeria cling onto the clay-like soil to support the large biomass of the tree on the hydric soil and prevent the soil from being washed away. In the middle zone, it is common to find the rhizophora trees with tall stilt and prop roots, which are submerged during high tide and are indicative of significant water level change. You might even find the tree-climbing crabs scaling the prop roots to escape the high tide. During low tide, the waterlogged mud is exposed and you might find the pencil-like roots of the api-api poking out to take in atmospheric oxygen. If you are fast enough, you might even catch a mudskipper hopping across. The middle zone has the highest diversity of trees, so one might even find the dramatic-looking nipper palm. Nearing the sea, the low-lying land is perpetually flooded in low and high tide. So, long conical and thick pneumatophores of the mangrove apple poke out to take in atmospheric oxygen and anchor the soil against tidal erosion. Can you tell the difference between the mangrove apple and the api-api? In this seaward zone, you should watch your hip as the strange-looking cannonball mangrove has fruits up to the size of pomelos. Watch out for the eyes in the water too, as saltwater crocodiles may be lurking. Another fantastic part about mangroves is that they thrive in harsh environments that would kill other trees. The waters are brackish, meaning that the water has different levels of saltiness or salinity at different times of the day. Another key stressor is that they grow in hydric soils. Hydric soil refers to soil with little to no air spaces in the soil and are typically filled with water. Mangroves have specialized adaptations to thrive in these conditions that make them particularly useful as coastal defense against large waves or sea level rise. Ecologists use a handy instrument called the horiba, which measures key hydrology indicators along with salinity. The best part about mangroves is that they are fantastic at carbon sequestration and can store up to 10 times the amount of carbon as compared to terrestrial forests. Ecologists estimate the amount of carbon stored by measuring the diameter breast height of the tree using a survey tape. They also estimate the height of the tree using a clinometer. So, how can we as neighbors to mangroves do our part to protect them? Firstly, take a walk through your neighboring mangrove. As you get more familiar with your mangrove, you will start to better understand the threat that it faces. Secondly, get involved. There are many organizations in Singapore that organize mangrove cleanups or tree planting events, and we need as many hands as we can get on board. Lastly, make friends with your neighborhood Ministry of Parliament. They represent your voice and your concerns regarding the future of mangroves in the Parliament. Mangroves need all the help they can get from you and I. Conversely, mankind needs all the help that we can get from mangroves in our survival against climate change. So, take a walk today. Sinto teu desejo a querer o teu beijo e na rua uma lua de mel. Os meus pés no chão e a sedução da flor encravada nos cabelos em trança, o balanço nos braços como aves suaves batendo as asas.